There was an earthquake, amen, somebody. There was an earthquake, and at the time of the earthquake, that the stone rolled away. Now we have to question that detail, because none of the other gospels mention an earthquake. And what does that mean? Does that mean that there was an actual earthquake, or does it mean that something, some greater force, some higher power shifted the atmosphere and allowed the stone to be rolled away? I wish I had a witness this morning who knows that every once in a while a higher power comes in and shakes the foundation. I wish somebody knew that every once in a while something happens that we cannot explain, we cannot interpret, but thanks be to God that things happen that we cannot control, because God is wiser than we are. God not only knows our beginning, but God knows our future. I wonder if anyone knows that our future is in the hands of the Most High God. We don't have all the details, but we know that Jesus went into the tomb.
Yes.
And because I'm just a curious kind of person, I went to this tomb. Amen, somebody. I went to the tomb of Jesus, and I found this stone, the most famous stone that ever was on this earth. And I asked this stone, what happened? What happened to Jesus? What happened in that space of time between the time where he was put into this tomb and the time these women came back to see him? The stone did not mind talking to me. Amen, somebody. As a matter of fact, the stone was a willing participant in my investigative research. Amen. See, I didn't have to beg the stone to talk to me, but the stone was willing. I asked the stone, "Stone, what happened? Stone, what did you see? What did you hear? Can you provide any clarity on this resurrection mystery?" And the stone talked back to me, amen. The stone said, I was laying here in the desert on this mountain minding my own business. And this man brought another man. I didn't know either one of them, but this man brought this other man. He was carrying him, and he put him in this tomb. And then he came over to me. He chose out of all the other stones and rocks, he chose me. And I don't know about you, but I'm glad I've been chosen. Amen, somebody. We're not all chosen to be pastors. We're not all chosen to be priests, but we've all been chosen to be witnesses. Amen. The stone, he said, I was chosen, and I was rolled over the face of this tomb. And I said, well, stone, what did you see? The stone said, I looked at the man who was in the tomb, and I said, man, somebody must have been really upset with him, because he had holes in his wrists. He had holes in his ankles. He even had a stab wound in his side. He had holes all around his head, like somebody put a crown of thorns on his head. I said, somebody was really, really mad at him. And I stopped by to tell you this morning that your scars tell your story. Amen, somebody.